Today, we're knitting along a pet bandana. As long as you know how to cast on and make a knit stitch, you can make this. It easily slips right onto your current pet's collar here. We've got three different sizes, a small, medium, and large. You can choose to keep it solid and work with scrap yarn. You could make it a gradient. You could even stitch on your pet's initial or their whole name, or even try this fun little paisley design, and I'll have the pictures to that on our blog. We've got the free pattern for you down at the description link below. Let's get started and stitch this along together. Welcome to Good Knit Kisses. We're all about helping you stitch your love and love your stitches. First, this is Ranger. Don't you love him? He is modeling our large size pet bandana and he just loves his. I made it out of wool to wick the moisture away from him and it doesn't start absorbing. So keep that in mind when you're choosing your yarn. That's just a cool property of a wool yarn, but this is a great stash buster project. You don't have to work with wool. You can use acrylic or whatever. I just wouldn't recommend a cotton yarn because it's going to absorb the moisture too much. And then you're just going to have a wet bandana that can just irritate around their skin. All right, so let's jump into more information. Go click down the video description below to get this pattern. It's free on our blog, or if you want it ad-free and support Good Knit Kisses, you can buy it through our Ravelry and Etsy stores, which we'll have a link in that description box or at the blog. Now, again, this comes in the three sizes. This is a fully captioned video, so click on the CC button to turn that on. The yarn I'm using is a bulky 5-weight yarn. You can use a super bulky 6 or a chunky yarn. I'm using Red Heart and Italian Story Vera, and this is a color Note, which is that blue color in his bandana. There's also Pietra, which is a gray, and Cafe, which is a brown kind of color. I'm using a US 9 or 5.5 millimeter circular needle. You can also use a straight. The size of needle I'm using is just a little bit smaller than it's recommended with this yarn, and that's because I want it like a nice tighter stitch so it's not too loose. I just want my gauge a little bit tighter. A stitch marker is a good idea just to mark your right and wrong sides, just for some of the instructions, and then a tapestry needle if you want to measure, which we do call out some measurements rather than rows. If you're using this this one, you don't have to measure, but I left the measurements in there, so use a measuring tape. And then also, if you want to use this technique, slip stitch crochet, and do what I did here to make an initial or a name or this little paisley design, you're going to need a crochet hook for that. And we do have a video on techniques for slip stitch crochet on top of knitting down at the links below. Let's look at sizes before we dive right in, just so you know what I'm referring to off camera. I'm going to work on this small size, which is almost 7 inches wide. It's 6.75 inches by 5.5 inches. That is, the width is across where the collar is on, and then the length is from the middle of the collar down to the point of the triangle here. Okay. And then I've got the centimeters over here if you need that. The second size is a medium. It's 8.5 inches by 6.5 inches. And the large is 9 inches by 7.25. You can make these a little bit longer, and I'll show you that area in the pattern. And you can also add on more stitches. You can cast on, just make sure it's an odd number of stitches. So you can make it wider or more narrow. If you're going to make it smaller than the small, if you have a teacup size animal, then like it want an extra small, then I suggest using a smaller needle and a smaller yarn, and you could try these cast-ons and see what that size looks like. If you're working with scraps, it's still a good stash buster, so that's a great way to test that out. All right, let's begin. There is a left and right handed video of this tutorial, so click down in the video description below to get the one that you need. I'm going to refer to your working needle with this hand and your non-working needle with this hand, and instead of saying right and left. All right, so if you want to use straights, go ahead and grab those. If you're using circular, I'll be using that. It's the same technique either way. I've got my stitch marker to mark my right side. And if you don't want to see me how to make the long tail cast on, if you know how to do that already, go ahead and cast on 27 stitches for the small, 33 for the medium, and 37 for the large. All right, we're going to pull out 3 times the width that we need for our little pet bandana. I got my tail. I'm going to pull out about 7 inches and do that 2 more times. And then we're going to make a slip knot. The way I make mine is I wrap it over my finger twice, take the back loop slightly over in front of the front loop, And then now take the new back loop up and over the tip of your finger and you have your slip knot. Then I'm going to put the tail part toward me and the ball part towards the back. Put in my needle, tighten that loop up. Not too tight, we don't want it to fall off, but we don't want it to be too loosey-loosey. So we're gonna grab that with our hand and split the yarn with our fingers. We're gonna take our needle and go up at the thumb, and then we're gonna go around to the finger part, go down, and then we're gonna bring that part from the finger through that thumb, so down at the thumb. And then I'm gonna put my finger on here to make sure we got a good gauge here, give it good spacing. Let's do that again. So we're gonna go up at the thumb, around and down at the finger, and then down through the thumb again, and grab that and tighten it up, okay? So the part from the thumb makes that little twisted part in the front. If you need a slower tutorial, we do have beginner tutorials down at the video description link below really help you with that, and also the knit stitch. One more time, up at the thumb, down at the finger, down at the thumb, and let it go. Go ahead and cast on 27 stitches for small, 33 for the medium, and 37 for the large. Pause your video and I will see you at that point. See you soon. All right, we are on row one, and we're gonna go ahead and just simply knit across. So insert your needle into that first stitch, yarn over, pull through that loop, and drop off the old one. Again, go into that first stitch, yarn over, pull up that loop, drop the old one off. If you need a slower tutorial, please be sure and go down in the description below to get that. Knit across. Once you've got a few on here, you could go ahead and put your stitch marker on to mark your right side. I just like to go through that stitch right here. This is the stitch from the cast on. That's that little purl bump you see. And we're gonna make that purl bump side our right side, and you'll see why later. I think it's a lot easier because we're gonna be picking up these stitches to make this open end of the casing, and it works out really well. So go ahead and knit across all your stitches, pause your video, and I'll talk about the next step. See you soon. All right, so you've knit row one, and now we're going to be repeating that row one until 2.5 inches for the small, 3 for the medium, and 3.5 inches for the large. If you're working with the yarn I have, then you're gonna work 20 rows for the small, 24 for the medium, and 28 for the large, and end on a wrong side row. So that stitch marker is significant, so go ahead and put that on there. Work those stitches while pausing the video, and I'll meet you back up for casing for the collar. See you soon. So you've worked your knitted length. This is about 2.5 inches for my small, 3 for the medium, and 3.5 for the large. So now what we're doing is we're moving on to the row. We're going to fold up our knitting to the back like this. See, I'm on the right side where my stitch marker is. We're gonna fold it up like this and start working across, and we're basically hemming it as we go instead of stitching it together with a needle and thread. That's what we're doing. So it makes this little casing. It's like an open-ended pocket that slides your collar right through. So let me show you the pattern. So this is the casing for the collar, row two. Insert knitwise through first stitch and pick up first stitch from cast on, pulling through as to knit. So let's do that right now. All right, I'm on my right side. I'm gonna fold up my knitting and take my working yarn. I'm gonna move this tail out to the side. I'm not gonna worry about that right now. And we're gonna go to this very first stitch back here, and this is what we're gonna work through. So we're gonna go through the first stitch on our needle, and then we're gonna go through this first stitch on our cast on edge. And then you just knit as normal. You're going to knit through both. So we're gonna yarn over, pull through this first one, and I kinda just pull on the knitting like this to kind of get it through if it's a little tough. And then you just pull it through that stitch, just like you're doing a regular knit stitch, okay? Now we're gonna go through the next one as to knit, but don't forget to pick up that very first stitch. So let's look back here at our cast on. The very next stitch is this one, okay? So see how I just kind of pull it back, go through that stitch, and then I take my yarn. This is just like picking up stitches if you've ever picked one up from the neck or something like that, doing the same thing. We're just going to yarn over, pull through like that, and then we're just picking that stitch up and then pulling it through to make a stitch over here and then pulling it off. So you've basically worked this as a little tube here, and you're going to keep going across. So you just continue on the next stitch, go through the next stitch knitwise. Let's take off this stitch marker so you can really see it. And then I'm going to pull back my knitting, and you can see that my next stitch is this one here. And then we're going to knit that, pull through to make a stitch, and then we're just pull that right through that very first stitch. All right, so continue knitting and picking up stitches as you go. Okay, pull it back and just study it. You can see these are the nice big stitches across the front, and if you're on the back, they were these little purl bump stitches. So ignore the ones in the back and just go through the looser ones up front. If you're not sure, just kind of move your needle across and look at them this way and backwards and kind of fall back until you get to the very next one. See, there's that loose one. Go ahead and pick that up and then pull through to make a knit stitch. All right, continue all the way and I'll meet you at the very last one. See you in a moment. All right, I've got my last stitch here and I picked up what was mostly the last loose stitch on my cast on, but there is one more and I've got one more stitch here. So we're gonna go through that and find, oops, it's easy to do. Just put that right back in. Hold it with my thumb here. I'm gonna find this very last stitch here, right on that edge. Make sure I'm going through all the yarn and not splitting it, which I keep doing. There we go. It's a little bit tighter here. Just gonna yarn over and pull through, use my thumb, and you can see my needle kept dropping off, but that's okay because it's already inserted through this stitch correctly, and so you can just knit it right over. And I love that it's actually nice and tight because I want this to be a nice and secure spot here for this casing. Okay, I went ahead and put my stitch marker on so you can see we were on our right side, and when we turn over, we're on the wrong side, and really from this point on, it doesn't matter right or wrong side, but I just did that for reference for you. So the next row, row three, we're going to knit across. So go ahead and knit across, pause your video, and I will meet you back up for the next step. We'll see you soon. Row three, you're going to be repeating to get a length, and then we're going to start decreases. So you're going to work five rows for the small size and six rows for both the medium and the large. If you do want your length from the middle of the collar area down to the point, if you want that area longer, then you just knit more rows, as many as you'd like. And then when you stop, it's going to be at this point here, and then you start your decreases. So right now we're working with this little middle section here. And again, it doesn't matter if you're on the right or wrong side, it's just going to be a knitting length. So go ahead and knit five more times for small and then six times for the medium and large. Pause your video and I will see you at the decrease area. See you soon. You've knit your length and now we're just going to start our decrease row, and row four is going to be repeated through the end of the pattern until you get to three stitches left. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to knit the first stitch. Then we're going to knit two together. So you go into the second stitch knitwise, like you're going to knit, but go through both stitches, yarn over, and pull up a loop, that new stitch, drop the old off, and then knit to the end of the row. That's it. So you're just decreasing by one at the beginning of each row. So I'll repeat that in just a moment. Go ahead and knit through, pause your video if you need. And I'll repeat that again slower for those who need it. Okay, we're going to repeat that row, knit the first stitch, knit two together, go into the second stitch, all the way through the first stitch. Yarn over and pull through both loops, just like that, and then let them fall off. Knit to the end. Go ahead and repeat that row until you only have three stitches left, and we'll see you at that point. See you soon. All right, we have three stitches left on our needles, and we want to do a center double decrease. So we're going to be slipping these first two stitches. It's slip two, knit one, pass the two slip stitches over. So this is how you do that. You're going to go in as if you were going to knit both two stitches together, except then you just slide off your non-working needle. So it slips them over knit-wise over here. And so the first stitch that's on there is your center one. And then this will make everything line up really nice to a point. So then we're going to knit into the second stitch, okay? And then we're going to slip these two, or pass these two stitches over. So one and two. And then you're left with this center stitch. So you just pull on it, go ahead and cut your yarn, pull that out. And now you have a nice pretty point on your knit bandana, and you can just take your tapestry needle and weave in the tail. So I have a video on how to weave in tails, and you can click down at that link below or in the cards here, but you can just weave it in to either side. This happens to be the wrong side, that's the right side. It doesn't really matter, but notice that the only difference really here is this right side looks kind of smooth and this side has a little bitty line on it. It doesn't really matter. I usually weave in my tail into what's gonna be the back. So I just kind of go up right through here, pull that through, and go on up until I can get into the garter stitch. And then I'm just going to, let's see, go up one more row here. I'm gonna go around this little umbrella sort of stitch here, go down through that little sort of smile, and then come down to this other row down here through this little umbrella, pull through, and go around this little smile area and come up and go back up through that little smile here like that, and then go around again. So that's how I do it. If you want a slower tutorial, again, you can go click on that link for weaving in your tails in garter stitch. And once you have this in here really well, then I just suggest that you go back over a few stitches and maybe kind of go through one and split the yarn, and then you can trim that off. Use the same technique on this part up here. Just make sure that you're not stitching through your casing. You're only working on one side of it, or go down into this part here, and you are done. I can't wait to see your pet bandana. Please be sure and use hashtag pet bandana on Instagram and tag me at goodknitkisses. I would love to see yours. Give me a comment down below if you want to send me the link, or just comment and tell me which color you made. I would love to know. Join us for our next tutorial and subscribe to not miss any.
Thanks for joining us today, where we help you stitch your love and love your stitches. See you again soon.